If like me, you love oil to milk gel type cleansers, but you don't always have the time and energy to make them, then I have the perfect alternative for you. The star ingredient of this cleanser is polyglycerol 4-oleate, which I will call PG4O from now on. It is Cosmos and ECOCERT approved. It is effective and gentle at removing makeup and turns milky and rinses off upon contact with water. I have read really mixed experiences with PG4O. In this video, I will give you some tips on how to improve the rinse-off ability of this product and make it work for you. The choice of oils is very important in the skin feel of this product. You want to opt for light oils like sunflower, grapeseed, apricot, hemp, and camellia oils, and avoid heavy oils like coconut, olive, castor, avocado, macadamia, or rice bran oils. Whether an oil is heavy or light seems to be mostly determined by its molecular weight as well as the types of fatty acids it contains. Since this is a wash-off product, I find it's perfect to use oils that you don't like so much or maybe will pass their best before date soon. I won't tell if you don't. I like to structure my oil cleanser in three parts. Part one is the bulk oil. This makes up most of your formulation and is ideally a light oil that is cheap. I like using sunflower or safflower oil for this. Part two is the special oil. This is another light oil which makes the product feel more exciting. Maybe it also offers a special scent or color to the product. This could be broccoli, camellia, hemp, or passion fruit seed oil. I don't use these as the bulk of my formula though, as they are quite expensive and resource intensive. Part 3 is the ultra light oil. This could be a silicone replacement which improves the skin feel of the product and aids in rinse off. Some options here would be Caprylate Capric Triglyceride, Coco Caprylate, and Isomyl Laurate. Altogether, this creates a well-balanced product. Like I mentioned before, some people have found that PG4O does not rinse off well at all. That kind of makes sense as it is a water and oil emulsifier, so it will show more affinity to oil rather than water. However, I believe the way to maximize this product comes down to the types of oils you choose and also how you use this product in your routine. I find it works wonderfully at removing makeup. I'm also a fan of just using a cream cleanser as a second step that will remove any residue without stripping the skin. I use my Coco cream cleanser for this. What I'm referring to is the double cleanse method, where you start with an oil-based cleanser to remove makeup and sunscreen, which are heavier, and the oils dissolve this better than the water-based cleansers would. Plus, oil-based cleansers are typically more gentle for your eye area, as you don't have to rub the product aggressively to get the makeup off. This can be in oil, gel, or balm form. After rinsing off that first layer, you might notice that there is still a slight oil film on your skin. It will not be as bad as using straight-up oils for cleansing because oil-to-milk cleansers contain an emulsifier that makes the removal process much easier. This is the job of our PG4O or other similar ingredients like sucrogel. To remove the second layer, a foaming cleanser is used. This could be any kind of cleanser you like, whether it is in cream, gel, or mousse form. Double cleansing makes sure that your skin is clean and ready to absorb any lovely actives we apply afterwards via our serums or moisturizers. Oil cleansing originates from Asia, and although it gained a lot of popularity lately, it has been used for a long time in Japan and Korea in the 14th century to remove the white paint-like base women were wearing. Making this is so easy, I don't even need to film this, but simply add your oil mix to the PG4O. In the video, I did the other way around for visual effect. Finally, add the vitamin E and fragrance. Fragrance is rather optional. I really love the smell of petit gras in this. It's extracted from the leaves and twigs of the bitter orange tree, and it just reminds me of the Mediterranean. I think 0.20% is just enough to get a bit of aromatherapy without stinging the eyes. Especially in that eye area, you want to avoid essential oils. I think it's best to test it out and see for yourself, as everyone is different on that matter. Remember to check out my blog for the free formula, including an interactive calculator, in case you want to upscale or downscale it. If you like this type of cleanser, check out my other oil to milk cleanser, which has a very beautiful and special texture. Or you might like to try my balm cleanser, which also uses PG4O and an emulsifier to create a nice balm to cream texture upon contact with water.